Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you the fastest way of installing n8n plus Mautic on your own VPS in literally a few seconds. Now it's going to be a few minutes, but it's the fastest way. I prepared everything for you and it's super easy. So yeah, stop wasting time with hours of tutorials and just get going. So I'll take you along here. Go to automatethis.pro/the-stack. Of course, you don't need to use this Docker Compose file, but I recommend you to do it. Everything, so we are hosting Mautic professionally and we build n8n for our clients, because we cannot host it because it's forbidden to host it, but our clients like to have it, so we are installing it for them. We are creating all these necessary things in order that they can have their own files and quadrant databases and so on and so forth. So we combined all this knowledge into this script in order for you to get going within a few seconds. So I'll take you along. Go to automatethis.pro/the-stack and get the stack. So if you click get the stack, you can check out here really quickly. I will just show you here with dummy data. Later on, this will not be dummy data anymore. So, and give me a name. And from here, yeah, you can have, yes, okay, let's go. Pay. Okay, you can save that, blah, 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 all this stuff. And if the purchase went through, you can download your stack. Then you have your download file here. So that's the ATM stack version 1. Yes, you can download it. And then you need to open your own VPS. But anyways, there is a referral link where we get 10 euros in credits for each person who signs up. Plus you get $20 or euros, I think it's euros, 20 euros credits if you use our referral link. So use this link, then you get to Hetzner and there you create your own project. So I go here into my new project. You can create your resource. So you click create resources, servers, open your new VPS, build it wherever you need. I will do this here in Germany, Ubuntu, shared vCPU. I recommend using CPX 31 or if you want CPX 41, because it depends on how many subscribers you have in Mautic, like how many emails and how much traffic you have on your website if you use the Mautic tracking. so, but anyways, everything starting from CPX 31 is going to be good. So yeah, I would use this one for this tutorial. Yes, and in n8n, it depends if you're planning to have like 5 workflows, nothing matters. It's totally fine. But if you're planning to have hundreds of workflows running each time with cron or with something, then I strongly recommend at least getting the CPX 41, if not a stronger one. So yeah, choose your server and from there, add an SSH key. If you don't know what an SSH key is, it's totally fine. They have a really good tutorial here. But otherwise, you just get your root credentials with a password sent to your email address, which is fine. I'm going to use the SSH key because it's nice. Add some backups. Backups are done every day for the last 7 days, which is great. So you don't have to worry about backups. If something goes wrong, you can just roll back, which is amazing. And then give it a name. In my case, I will call it test tutorial stack, whatever. Create and buy. This takes a few seconds and it's there. Nice. It's really, it's so fast. Hetzner is amazing. It's really amazing. I love them. And the support is great too. So, okay, copy the address, then open your terminal. Okay, in the terminal, you write SSH root at and your IP address, which you can click and copy here. And then you need to add it to your trusted hosts and add your password. And now you're here. So the first thing we are going to do in every server which we are setting up is, of course, we update our server. So apt update. And what we are going to do is we're going to install unzip, because we need to unzip a folder. So apt install unzip. Nice. And then we're going to apt upgrade. This is pretty much something you should do each time when you go into your VPS. So yeah, if you're a non-technical person, don't worry about it. Just put in apt upgrade, apt install unzip, and that's it. It's totally fine. And as soon as it's upgraded, you need to add the archive you just downloaded from our website. So open another terminal and find the file here in your folder. So let's push it there. Let's do scp. Let's take the file and root at. What do we have here? This one. And then we want to put it into our /forward/ folder. So, okay, log in. So if you do the same thing what I'm doing, you get prompted exactly the same way. So, okay, now we uploaded it to our folder. So in here, let's clear this. In here, if you do ls, there is nothing. If you go to this first folder and do ls, then you see the stuff. And we just push the file there. So copy that and unzip. Unzip it exactly here as it is. I made everything to make sure that it's exactly the easiest and nicest and smoothest way you can have. So it's the ATM stack is here. Go in there, cd, the ATM stack. And in here, you have everything you need. So the one thing which is also there is the .env file, the environments file. So go in there, nano.env, and change these values to your values. So in here, the only thing you need to do here is add your domain name. So oforkdat.com. That's my domain I'm going to use for this tutorial. Then, of course, SSL email, you should change this. You should, of course, create strong passwords and then save out here. And from here, the only thing you need to do, and this is the super magic which is happening now, is you need to start Docker. So we are going to apt install docker compose. That's the one thing we're going to do here. And during the installation here, this is actually really fast, but during the installation, we need to make sure to point our domain to this server, to this VPS. So let's copy the IP address of the VPS again. Let's go into the DNS, the domain name system of our domain. So if you want to run something on the internet, you need a domain, of course. I hope you know that. If you don't, now you know it. Get a domain at some place. I recommend Route 53 from Amazon. They're great. And there you can create a record in your hosted zone. So I will do I will point a wildcard record to my IP address. Create. And from here, I'll just show the status as soon as this is, yes, it's in sync. So everything is going to show to this website. So now the only thing you need to do and watch the magic happen is add docker-compose-up-d. The only thing is you need to wait. So, but no space to make errors, which is great. I love this so much. Because we made the errors for you before. Like hours and hours and hours of trial and error and making it right. Okay, so everything is done. Let's see if it worked. So let's open a new window in our browser, a new tab, and type n8n.oforkthat.com. And it's here, set up owner account. So you set up your owner account, suggest strong password, next. No, I'm not gonna save. Get started. Yes, amazing. This is n8n. So you can start your first workflow from here or use the other thingy, templates and so on. Everything is here. So this is great and it's working out of the box. Plus you have Quadrant already running. Plus you can add files to your server within here and work with files inside n8n. So we set up everything for you in order to get going without thinking about, oh my God, how can I have a vector store now? Or how can I work with images on my n8n? Because you need to have your folders set correctly. So everything is done, everything is working fine. Okay, and now let's see if Mautic is working. So go to mautic.oforkthat. And there you go, login. Everything is installed. So you don't even have to run through the installer because Docker did everything for you. Everything is done. So you can directly log in. Okay, and now we can log in with our standard user data and the password you gave it in the .env file, which is admin plus your password, login. Yes, here we go. Everything nice. You can change everything from here within your account. You should change your username and so on. So everything works. And the other cool thing we built in here is inside the plugins, you have Amazon SaaS already pre-installed, plus the housekeeping plugin from Leuchtfeuer, which are really amazing. The cron jobs are running and so on and so forth. Everything is working out of the box. So if you want to spend hours, do some other tutorials. If you want to spend only a few minutes, follow this tutorial, get your Docker file and you're good to go. And everything is pre-installed and predefined and pre-made for you. So you have a better life. Amazing. See you next time.